Okay, so let's think a little bit about the LEA instruction. So LEA stands for load effective address. And you'll see that it takes two operands, so it takes a source, quote unquote, and a destination. The source operand needs to be a memory operand. And what the instruction does is it calculates the effective address of that memory operand, and it stores that address in the destination register. So the odd thing about it is that it doesn't actually read memory from the source operand, it just calculates the effective address of that operand. So this is a useful thing to do, but one thing that the LEA and one thing about the LEA instruction is that it's extremely fast. And compiler writers over the years have taken advantage of this in ways that might confuse you the first time that you see it. And so the book highlights this, and I wanted to highlight it as well in case you see this in assembly dumps and wonder what's going on. So let's think about this instruction here. So what does this instruction do if the value of RAX is hex 100? So we have LEAQ, and then we have this memory operand, which is in scaled indexed addressing mode. And then we have a destination register RAX. So take a moment to think about this and make a hypothesis about what this instruction is going to do. Okay, so this is the memory operand, and we said that the LEA instruction is going to calculate the effective address of that operand, and it's going to store that effective address in this operand. Again, it's not going to read memory, it's just going to do an effective address calculation. So remember, the effective address calculation for this addressing mode is going to be the value of this register plus the value of this register times the index, or the scale, sorry. So if the value of RAX is hex 100, we're going to have 100 plus 2 times 100, which is 200. So basically, we're going to get hex 300. And that is the value that is going to be stored in RAX. Again, we don't access memory at this location. We just take this value and store it into RAX. So if you think for a second, what we've actually done here is we've multiplied RAX by 3. Without actually doing a multiplication instruction. And it turns out that this is actually faster than running a generic multiplication instruction and multiplying by the constant 3. So sometimes compilers will actually emit a load effective address instruction instead of a multiplication or addition if it can encode that instruction or that operation as an LEA. So it's kind of a weird caveat, but I wanted to mention it in case you run into it at some point this semester.